Good morning, Broadway. Oops. I forgot to take off my mask. Good morning, Broadway. Remember to wear your mask when you are outside or in public places. Thanks to Dorian Poole, who made this one for me. It's Palm Sunday without palms. It's tense, confusing, and a little scary. That's a lot like the first Palm Sunday. It started out as a very quiet Sunday morning, but soon a crowd began to gather. A crowd like we can't imagine right now. But like that first Holy Week, we ask ourselves the question this morning, which we are all asking ourselves these days. What crossroads are we at in our lives?
And now as we gather together, please light a candle and place it somewhere near where you are. Feel free to post a picture of your candle, if you wish, in the comment section on this worship service. If you're at home, you can join Gisele as she plays and sings Hosanna, Loud Hosanna, this familiar Palm Sunday hymn. It was written by a woman named Jeanette Thrale Fall in the 1800s. She particularly envisioned the role that children played in Palm Sunday, and we are told that the children were shouting Hosanna in the temple. So the song moves to and points to the importance of children around Jesus. We need to receive children so we can see God's realm around us. So let's listen now.
Today's gospel lesson comes from the book of Matthew. When they had come near Jerusalem and had reached Bethphage at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately you will find a donkey tied and a colt with her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, just say this, 'The Lord needs them,' and he will send them immediately." This took place to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet, saying, "Tell the daughter of Zion, 'Look, your king is coming to you, humble and mounted on a donkey, and on a colt, the foal of a donkey.'" The disciples went and did as Jesus had directed them. They brought the donkey and the colt, and put their cloaks on them, and he sat on them. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, and others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowds that went ahead of him and that followed were shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest heaven!" When he entered Jerusalem, the whole city was in turmoil, asking, "Who is this?" The crowds were saying, "This is the prophet, Jesus, from Nazareth in Galilee."
Every Sunday we have what we call here the lesson from the contemporary church. It's a time when we remind ourselves that God didn't stop speaking when the book went to press, but continues to write in our lives and stories. Today, bringing us the lesson from the contemporary church are Mike Schaefer, Andy Grigley, and Kayla Goodfellow. Thanks for doing this.
My name is Mike Schaefer. What are the crossroads in my life? The crossroads of approaching an age where your daughter lectures you about the coronavirus and not going out and about. It makes me feel like I'm at a new stage in my life. Definitely a role reversal.
Good morning, Broadway. My name is Andy Grigley. Mike contacted me a few days ago to answer the question about what crossroads am I at in my life. And to be honest with you, the crossroads that I'm at right now is with this virus and not knowing where we're going or what's going to happen. It is a big concern. So all I can say is we'll just keep fighting. Stay strong, Broadway, and we'll see you soon.
Good morning, friends. My name is Kayla Goodfellow, and we're talking about crossroads. I kind of think of both short-term crossroads and long-term crossroads. And I think everyone is experiencing a lot of short-term crossroads. And ours are that we now have 3 children home for the rest of the school year. And so our home is turned into an educational center and is bustling always with kids who want snacks and things to do and need a referee now and then. So that's definitely the short-term challenge. Our long-term challenge, I think, is less conventional than a lot of crossroads, and I'm thankful for that because there's been plenty of years that have involved moves and job changes and big educational changes and family changes. So I'm thankful that we're kind of in a smaller, more nuanced stage of crossroads. The kids over the last few months have learned how to ride their bikes. And I kind of think of that as a metaphor for the crossroads that we're at right now, because we're finally able to get out and start exploring the world. There was a long time where it was hard to get out and we frankly didn't do it very often. So now we've kind of hit the road and we're able to do more, explore more. And I think that metaphor works in the career sense for me as well, which is great. It's a new stage of empowerment. And so the crossroads, I think, is what to do with that empowerment and what to do as my family goes out and explores the world a little more. Thank you.
He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands.
He's got you and me, brother. In his hands, he's got you and me, brother. In his hands, he's got you and me, brother. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the itty bitty babies. In his hands, he's got the itty bitty babies. In his hands, he's got the itty bitty babies. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands.
He's got you and me, sister. In his hands, he's got you and me, sister. In his hands, he's got you and me, sister. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands.
He's got you and me, sister.
In his hands, he's got you and me, sister.
In his hands, he's got the
you and me, sister.
In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands.
gospel lesson that Chris read began with Jesus going to the Mount of Olives. King David went in grief to the Mount of Olives because his son Absalom had a conspiracy against him. In the Hebrew scriptures, the Mount of Olives is the place where God will stand in order to defeat those who have gathered against Jerusalem. From the Mount of Olives, God will be known as ruler over all the earth. Jesus stands on the Mount of Olives, both in mourning and as one who announces a different kind of reign than has been imagined. Jesus comes, as Zechariah says, humbled and riding on a donkey. Here we are in what is often a day of celebration in the life of the church, and we don't feel much like celebrating. There are no palms to wave like we do. We didn't start outside like usual on Palm Sunday. We didn't march in singing. We are where we are. We are physically distant from one another, and yet we are together. Now the scripture says that the whole city was in turmoil, a parade day with fun and people shouting, and the city is in turmoil. The city is in turmoil. Not so different than today. Hosanna? Not so fast, then or now. Jesus is riding on a donkey and not a big majestic horse, like Caesar on the other side of town in another parade going on at the same moment. Thinking of the great Baptist preacher Carlisle Marney, who once preached a Holy Week sermon where he asked, "Where are the Lord's storehouses and the Lord's armies?" He asked because Jesus doesn't look like such a great ruler. Here we are, still stuck in our problems, in the evil of this world. And Jesus mocks the type of power we need. He rides in on a donkey. He has a disreputable group following him. He eats with tax collectors and sinners. He gets arrested. His followers desert him. He gets convicted. He is publicly humiliated. He is killed. He's the exact opposite of a ruler who cannot stop praising himself. A little bit like what you imagine Caesar might have been doing at his parade. He is the exact opposite of a ruler who parades himself around with military leaders and sycophants. Jesus' followers certainly couldn't be accused of being yes people. I must say that one of the gifts of this cursed pandemic has been seeing some realities that we didn't realize. Do all the people who are in jail need to be there? No. We have seen a drastic decrease in the jail population in Marion County. I saw the graph that looked like a ski slope. It plunged down over the month of March. Yet crime hasn't increased. What other realities have we become aware of? There are a lot more people out walking around than usual, and I say this as someone who walks around a lot. Maybe we are becoming more aware of the beauty and the nature of the city. What other realities? We can slow down. It's humanly possible. Other realities, our healthcare system can take care of everyone if they are sufficiently supported. Our economy, and particularly the people who have had the least amount of money, make a real contribution to our life together, take real risks in our life together, and deserve to be supported not just in times like these. They deserve the same support as the airline industry and Wall Street. If we do not take the lessons that come from this moment, it is like we have not learned the lessons of Palm Sunday. That someone can turn the world upside down from the back of a humble donkey. That someone who doesn't want the power of the machinery can invite us into deep love with one another. So this week, our granddaughter was born. Her name is Alexandra. We call her Zan. What a week to be born, huh? This little girl, just by showing up, has changed our world, our commitments, our place. It seems like the most insignificant thing, a little girl just a few days old. She can't talk, she can't argue, she can't walk, She can't play basketball. She can't feed herself. She can't clean herself up. She is entirely dependent upon those who love her and some who don't know her. And she has changed the world for us. I mean that literally. This is the way God's world is. It is little things that change us. It is not the big things. It's a birth, a death, a love, a promise, forgiveness, grace. What crossroads am I at? The crossroads of a new beginning in a faraway place near mountains and a very different community. How can I comfort people when I can't sit next to them? I sit at the crossroads with a granddaughter named Zan and wonder what does it look like to be present for her. I sit at a crossroads of how to say goodbye when we can't even be in the same room with one another. Little things change the world. A baby's new cry, a ruler's humility. Amen.
Please join with us as we enter into a time of prayer. Gracious God, you've heard the cries of your suffering people. You have sent Jesus to us to be our Redeemer and brother. Open our eyes to see the immensity of your love for us and the wonder of what you have done for us. Give us the courage to be your hands and heart for those who are in pain. Give us wisdom to speak out for justice and righteousness. May your will be done in us today and always. Amen. Thank you. join with me now as we affirm our mission. As followers of Jesus Christ, responding to God's love, our mission as the people of Broadway Church is to be a multicultural Christian community that in its ministry seeks, welcomes, and values all people.
Many thanks to all those who assisted in worship this morning, for Chris Simon, Reverend Alicia Wilson-Baker, to Gisele Dollinger, to Vickie Daniels and the members of the choir, to Kayla Goodfellow, Andy Grigley, and Mike Schaefer for the lesson from the Contemporary Church they each brought, to Dave Frauman, and of course the incomparable Jim Fore, whose technology skills brought this to life. We will gather each day during Holy Week. We will send out a separate email with the information on that. Following worship today, each of the worship services will have their own coffee hour, Zoom call, beginning at 10:30. If you don't know which link to click on in the posting about this worship service, you can text me at 317-696-5699. 317-696-5699, and I'll send you the link. Now receive the benediction. On this Palm Sunday, let us say to one another and to the world that love spread more quickly than a virus ever could. Go to love God and to love your neighbor. Amen.